Hello, my name is Marco. I come from Tallinn, Estonia. My gamer tag now is NKFC Morocco, as I'm part of this new big eSports club, Nõmme Kalju FC. If and when we're talking about similarities and differences between football in real life and in FIFA, for the most part, are the tactics and the gameplay. It's football, like in real life and in virtual reality, it's football. There are questions like, how do we press? Where do we press? Do we play defensively? Do we play attackingly? But the differences in those two, I think for the most part, are that in virtual football, you can abuse some of the game mechanics. If you're gonna do, for example, one thing over and over again, which can be really effective in FIFA, and if you're gonna do it in the real pitch, on the real pitch, at some point, your opponents, like, will get that you're only doing one thing and he will implement something that will like cancel it out. Most people, I don't think, can even comprehend what eSport is, and if we talk about like to what extent it has already grown and where can it grow, it's kind of mental, because it's like some dudes playing behind a screen and people are watching. It's basically like real football, or I don't know, whatever other sport that there is. When Nõmme Kalju first approached me, it was kind of surreal, because I was just doing my thing, like minding my own business. Yes, I've been always really competitive about playing FIFA, but I didn't believe it at first glance, I think. But I was open-minded. I came to the meetings, I listened, I saw the vision that was behind it, and I was really impressed. The possibilities for eSport players are kind of endless, I believe. It's possible for everyone, basically, to get to a high level if you put in the hours, if you work like really hard. It's not easy to get to the top tier levels, but there are no like set restrictions. So you can get yourself a console, you can get yourself a PC, just start out the game, put in the hours, and the like possibilities are almost endless. If you're a parent and your child wants to become an eSports player, that's not something to like frown upon, I believe. That's a real option nowadays. If I would try to encourage young people into the eSports, I would say that I started out like nowhere, basically. I was like some young kids behind the screen. I was like you, watching YouTube tutorials on how to make my passing work in FIFA, how to make tackling work in FIFA, how to attack, which is good, what is bad. And well, look at me now. Not that I'm like big or anything, but I'm at the start of a really great thing with a really big vision.